the class. Let us discuss about one more chapter of geography, that is about industries of Karnataka. So what is the importance of industry in the development of Karnataka, as well as its great contribution in the development of the nation, and what's the role played by these industries in day-to-day life of the people? Growth of industries plays an important role in the development of any state in the country. So for the development of the country, role of industry is very, very important, because already I told so many times that India is a agricultural land or agricultural country. Even though India is an agricultural country, but the development of industries are so important for the development of a country like India. Not giving too much importance to the agriculture, along with that, equal importance should be given to the development of industry. Then the development of the country is possible. That's why the role of industries, that is whether it is country or the nation or the state, but the role of industries are very, very important in the progress of the nation or the growth of the country. A state has this greater opportunity due to the presence of Karnataka has got great opportunity for the development as with the help of industries, because due to the presence of abundant mineral resources, raw materials, ideal climate, sufficient water, good transport system, skilled laborers, wide market and modern technology. These are very, very important factors that greatly determine the development of the nation. Why? Or the development of the country. Here, Karnataka is greatly blessed with the abundant mineral resources, raw materials, ideal climate, sufficient water, good transport system, skilled laborers, wide market system, and modern technology. All these are very, very important factors for the establishment of industry. And all these factors are well developed in the Karnataka. That's why Karnataka has considered as a great opportunity for the development. The industries range from agriculture-based small-scale industries to modern large-scale industries. The industries, that is agro-based industries, the agricultural-based industries, from small-scale industries to large-scale industries, everything is developed in the Karnataka. Sir M. Vishveshwaraya's contribution to the development of industries in Karnataka is remarkable. You learnt about Sir M. Vishveshwaraya in the 7th standard. And you learnt what was the contribution, great contribution of Sir M. Vishveshwaraya to Karnataka. So, his contribution to the development of industries, especially the development of industries in Karnataka, is remarkable. Believing in the motto, what was the main motto of Sir M. Vishveshwaraya? Industrialize or perish. Either give importance for the industrialization or else you perish or destroy. So this, the main motto of Sir M. Vishveshwaraya, industrialize or perish. He laid the foundation for many industries in the state. The main intention of establishing industry is nothing but to develop the state. Developing the state like Karnataka was the main motto. With the motto called industrialization of the state, if not possible, then destroy. Or the destruction sure, that is called as perish. That was the motto. With that motto, he was given importance for the establishment of more and more industries in Karnataka. He paved the foundation for the establishment of industries in Karnataka for the first time. After the hydroelectric power generation station was started at the Shivanasamudra in the year 1902, many industries producing essential goods and products are daily used came into existence. First, that is after the establishment, because it was great success of Karnataka state, that is establishment of hydroelectric power generation station at Shivanasamudra in the year 1902. So this encouraged for the development of other industries in Karnataka. Rice mills, tile factories, BDs and cigarettes, iron and brass found factories were established in Karnataka. So along with this hydropower station, other industries are established here: rice mills, tile factories, BDs, and cigarette factory, iron and brass foundries are the factories that are established in Karnataka. After 1923, many modern manufacturing units like iron and steel industry, soap factories, cotton and silk mills, paper industry, cement industry, paint, sugar industry, sandal, oil industries, etc. were started in Karnataka. So which are the major industries were established in Karnataka after 1923? The industries like iron and steel industry, soap factory industries or soap factories, cotton and silk mills, paper industry, cement industry, paint factories or industries, sugar industry, sandal oil industries, etc. were well developed in Karnataka and greatly contributed for the development of the state. In pre-independence era itself, Mysore province was a model state with respect to industries. So, before independence only, pre-independence period itself, Mysore developed as the well-developed industry city in Karnataka. The main reason for this was the interest of British and the Mysore kings. So, the main important thing that is for the development of Mysore city as a well-developed industrialized city in Karnataka, for that two main reasons. That is, first one is great encouragement given by the British, because during that period India was under the control of British, and one more thing, great support given by the Mysore kings. So because of this well development we have seen in the Mysore. After independence, the industrial policy of the central government enabled further industrial development. So after independence, the government of India introduced or implemented industrial policy. So this industrial policy further helped in the development of industries. As a result, many more factories were established. For instance, manufacture of aeroplanes, engineering, machine tools, HMT, BL, BL companies, that is the famous companies of watch, that is made by these companies, are made, watches are very famous in the world. Then iron and steel industry, aluminium industry and information technology, electronic, biotechnology industries. All these are well developed, well set in India, in Karnataka after the independence, that is especially the industrial policy introduced by the central government. The industries, all these factories were established in India as well as in Karnataka. Iron and steel industry, the first and foremost industry that plays important role in the development of the state as well as the nation, iron and steel industry. Karnataka occupies the pride of place by being the first state in South India to establish an iron and steel factories. Remember, first state in South India, not in India, South India, Karnataka occupies the first place in South India to establish as iron and steel industry. Sir M. Vishveshwaraya's foresight enabled an iron and steel industry to be set up at Bhadravati in Shivamogga district in the year 1923. So for the first time, iron and steel industry was established in Karnataka, that is in the year 1923, with the foresight of Sir M. Vishveshwaraya, the Diwan of Mysore, that is established at a place called Bhadravati in Shivamogga in the year 1923. That so that the rich and abundant iron ore deposit in the Baba Budangiri hills could be utilized. You know that Odisha is the largest producer of iron in India, and next to Odisha, that is Karnataka. So Karnataka, the place called Baba Budangiri hill, in that highest deposit of iron ore, and this deposit is completely utilized for the production with the establishment of iron and steel industry. This factory was named as Mysore Iron and Steel Industries Limited, famously called as MSIL. Mysore state, that is MS means Mysore, Iron and Steel Industries Limited. Later on, it was handed over to Steel Authority of India Limited. That is in the year 1989 and came to be called as SAIL. Steel Authority of India Limited, SAIL, that is in the year 1989. Before that, it is famously called as MSIL. Mysore Iron and Steel Industry Limited, later came to be called as SAIL, that is Steel Authority of India Limited. Today it is known as, it is famously known as Visveshwaraya Iron and Steel Industry. VISN, Visveshwaraya Iron and Steel Industry, or VISN, that is the present name of MSIL, that was established during the period of that is in Mysore in the year 1923 at Bhadravati. That is mainly that great contribution that is foresaid, what the dream saw by Sir M. Visveshwaraya has become true with the establishment of iron and steel industry of Bhadravati. The iron ore necessary for this factory that is supplied from Kemmallagundi, lime from Bandigudda, water from the Bhadra River and manganese from Sandur. So all these provided to this iron and steel industry. So the iron ore necessary, this factory is supplied from Kemmallagundi, that is whatever the iron ore is that is required for the industry, that is supplied from Kemmallagundi, and lime that is needed for that industry supplied from Bandigudda, water from Bhadra River and manganese from Sandur Taluk. In the beginning, firewood was used for the glass furnace. After the Sharavati Hydro Power Generating Station was established, hydroelectricity began to be used. So for the power, here finally Sharavati hydropower electricity provided power to this industry. At present, a special variety of steel and pig iron are produced. Very famous for this, a special variety of steel and pig iron are produced here. Another important iron and steel industry of Karnataka is the private sector owned Jindal. Jindal Vijayanagara Steel Limited, JVSL, famously called as JVSL, that is Jindal Vijayanagara Steel Limited, that is near Hospete in the Ballari district. It was established in 2001 at Torrengal in Ballari district. Using the latest forex technology, it produces iron and steel. And next to VISL, that is a Visveshwaraya Iron and Steel Industry, one more is a JISL, that is a Jindal Iron and Steel Industry of Ballari. So very famous in the Karnataka. And next important industry is a cotton textile industry. Cotton textile industry is one of the modern industries established by very early in Karnataka. It is an agro-based industry. Cotton textile industry is depending on agriculture. That's why it is called as agro-based industry. From ancient times, weaving cloth on hard looms was in practice in Karnataka. So from the ancient period itself, Karnataka as well as India is famous for hand looms. So here that is what is practiced in Karnataka as the production of cotton by following the cottage industry, that is the main occupation of the cottage industry, that is through hand looms. It is practiced even now in some of the places of Karnataka. The people are not depending on the machines. Even today they are depending on hand looms only. Whatever looms that is made out of, that is used, it is produced with the help of hand itself, not with the help of the machines. So Karnataka, some of the places of Karnataka, even today famous for hand looms. So it is practiced even now. Although cloth is produced from synthetic yarn and foreign cotton textiles are available, Indian cotton textiles are in so great demand in the market. Even though British looted the wealth of India, they supplied raw materials to the British to the England, and finally finished goods are supplied or dumped in India. But even today, India, the people of India and other parts of India are even given importance for the handlooms or handmade goods of or the cotton textiles of India. There was a great demand for Indian textile or Indian cotton textiles. The modern cotton mills were established towards the end of 19th century. Ginning and spinning mills were set up in the northern districts of Karnataka. So remember, that is after 19th century it was established. For the first time it was established in the North Karnataka. The first MSK cotton mill was set up in 1884 at Kalaburgi. The first imported MSK cotton mill was established in Kalaburgi, that is in the year 1884. Later cotton textile factories were started in Hubballi. So almost all the cotton textile industries were established in North Karnataka, first in Kalaburgi. During that period it was called as Gulbarga, and now it was called as, now present name of Gulbarga is Kalaburgi. And next to that, one more cotton textile factory was established in Hubballi. After 1900, big cotton textile mills were established, among them Bini Mills and Minerva Mills of Bengaluru, KR Mill of Mysore, Cotton Mill of Davanagere, etc. are famous, and they were established before independence itself. So all these factories, all these cotton textile industries are famous not only in India, in other parts of India. So next, after independence, cotton mills were set up in the northern Maidan where cotton was widely grown. Especially in northern part it was grown. So in that area cotton mills were established. Davanagere became the state's most important cotton textile industrial centers. Remember, in Karnataka, Davanagere became the state's most important cotton textile industrial center. So it is called Manchester of Karnataka. In India, Bombay or Mumbai is famously called as Manchester of Karnataka, because most of the cotton textile industries are situated highest in Mumbai. That's why it is famously called as Manchester of India. At the same time, Davanagere, highest cotton textile industries are located in Davanagere, because it is the place in England where we can see highest cotton textile industries. That's why it is called as Davanagere, is famously called as a Manchester of Karnataka. So remember, which district is famously called as Manchester of Karnataka? Davanagere. The reason is that most of the cotton textile industries are situated in Davanagere. There are ginning and spinning mills in Hubballi, Ilkal Sari, that is very famous, Ilkal, Gulagudda, Rabakavi, Bagalkote, Molapalmuru, Gadag Betakeri, Badami, Belagavi, Naragunda, Gokak, Ballari, Hunsuru, Nanjinagut, Periyapattana, and Chamarajanagara. So almost all are the first part, all are the north part, North Karnataka districts, and very famous for the ginning as well as spinning. That is, most of the cotton textile industries are located in these places. At present, there are 44 cotton mills in the state. Approximately 5.1 million meters of cotton cloth is produced annually. So that is a great achievement of Karnataka state, and great achievement of Karnataka and contribution of Karnataka to the development of the country, nation. Some cotton mills have been closed down more recently. The reason for this are, what was the main reason for the close down of these industries? That is, shortage of cotton, obsolete machines, then lack of electricity supply, increasing production cost, stiff competition from synthetic fiber cloth. So because of that, handlooms and some of the cotton textile industries got a great setback. The main reason is this. The following were the important reason for the decline of cotton industries in Karnataka: shortage of cotton, obsolete machines, lack of old model machines, lack of electricity supply, increasing production cost, stiff competition, severe competition, everywhere competition. Because of that, many industries were closed. In order to improve the situation in the textile industry in Karnataka, the state government has formulated a program, that is Suvarna Textile Policy. Suvarna Textile Policy 2008-13, and has established finished goods parks in 11 districts. So what is the program conducted by the government of Karnataka in order to protect the cotton textile industries? That is, the state government has formulated program called Suvarna Textile Policy 2008-13, and has established in 13 districts. That is, in 13 districts, and has established finished goods parks in 11 districts. In this way, it greatly encouraged the cotton textile industries in Karnataka. The purpose of this program is to export the goods from these industries to foreign countries. The main purpose of encouraging cotton textile in India or in Karnataka, that is to export the goods to the foreign countries. Karnataka ranks second in the country with regard to export of textiles. Remember, Karnataka has ranked second as related to the export of cotton textiles in India. Such parks are at Doddaballapura, Anekal, Belagavi, Mysore and Ramanagara. So all these cotton textile parks are established in some of the places at called places of Doddaballapura, Anekal, Belagavi, Mysore and Ramanagara. Next comes, that is sugar industry. The sugar industry is one of the Karnataka's most important and large-scale industry. Sugar industry is the most important and large-scale industry in Karnataka. It is also an agro-based, which depending on the agricultural activity, all factors necessary for the development of this industry are favored in the state. The whatever factors, whatever supply of water, or the electricity, whatever raw materials required for the establishment of sugar industry, everything is available in Karnataka. So that's why this received the important place in Karnataka. Sugar industry received important place in Karnataka. Sugarcane production requires humid climate. So what is the factors are important or determines the sugar industry? That factors like humid climate, power supply, local market, transport system. If it is available, if these factors of production is available, then the establishment of sugar industry is possible. So that is available in Karnataka. Humid climate, power supply, local market, transport system is available in Karnataka. That's why here we have number of sugar industries. This industry plays an important role in the economic development of Karnataka. Sir Francis Buchanan mentions in his writings that in the early part of 19th century itself, sugar was produced in Pallali. That is a place called Ashtagrama of Srirangapatna and Chikkaballapura. So that is a 19th century itself, early part of 19th century itself, there was an establishment of sugar industry was existed in Karnataka at a place called Ashtagrama of Srirangapatna or Pallali of Srirangapatna and Doddaballapura. According to whom? According to Sir Francis Buchanan mentions the important sugar industry of Shivamogga, Srirangapatna and Doddaballapura. Record shows that these towns were producing sugar in 1847 and had won prizes in the London exhibition. There are two factories already, they were busy producing sugar, and that was in 1847 and had won prizes from a London exhibition, because during that period India was under the control of British. So the goods were exhibited in London, and in that this sugar of Srirangapatna and Doddaballapura received the prizes. The first modern sugar industry, Mysore sugar companies or my soup, my sugar. It must be called as a my sugar or Mysore Sugar Company was established at Mandya in 1933. Until 1951, that was the only factory in the state. For the first time, Mysore Sugar Factory was established in 1933. From 1933 to 1951, that is only one sugar industry in the Karnataka. So, this is famously called as sugar. The Mandya is famously called as Sakkare Nadu, isn't it? So, because it is very famous for the sugar industry. Now there are 47 sugar industries in the state. Their total annual production is 339 lakh tons. 339 lakh tons, great contribution towards the development. So Karnataka stands third in the production of sugar in the country. So third largest producing, Karnataka is the third largest sugar producing country, state in the country. Next, distribution. The distribution of sugar industry in Karnataka is concentrated in the sugar growing areas, especially the districts in the catchment areas of Kaveri, Krishna and Tungabhadra rivers. Especially it is distributed near the river deltas of Kaveri, Krishna, Tungabhadra. There are more sugar industries in Belagavi and Bagalkota districts. Highest sugar industries are found in Belagavi and Bagalkota districts. Mandya, Mysore, Bidar, Vijayapura, Kalaburgi, Ballari and Davanagere districts are also significant for sugar industry. So the districts like Mandya, Mysore, Bidar, Vijayapura, Kalaburgi, Ballari and Davanagere are the major districts of the production of sugar. Bagasse and molasses, that is whatever raw remains after taking juice from the sugar cane, are the byproducts of the sugar industry. That is, one is bagasse and one more is molasses, is the important byproduct of sugar, and this bagasse is used for the manufacture of paper and fuels. Remember, this the bagasse of sugar is used for the manufacture of paper and fuel, and this molasses are used for the production of alcohol. So remember the byproducts and what is byproducts and what are the uses of the byproducts of sugar industry. Next comes paper industry. Paper is of great importance in the modern world. It is essential because each and everyone's life is depending on the paper, isn't it? So, as a teacher, as a student, you know that what is the importance of paper. So, whatever our future is, finally it is judged on the basis of the paper and pen. So, paper is of great importance in the modern world. It is essential for education, printing, newspapers and for propagation of culture. It is forest-based industries. Remember, the paper is a forest-based industry and even it is depending on some of the agro-based industry. Bamboo, wood pulp, grass and bagasse, cloth rugs, that is the old cloth and waste, are used as a raw material for the manufacture of paper. So, what are the raw materials that is used for the production of paper? That is bamboo, wood pulp, grass, bagasse, cloth rags and waste are used as raw material for the manufacture of paper. The first paper mill, Mysore Paper Mill Limited, was established in 1936 at Bhadravati. So remember, the first important paper industry was established at a place called Bhadravati in Karnataka, established in the year 1936, that is Mysore Paper Mill Limited. Mysore Paper Mill Limited was established in 1936 at Bhadravati. Later, a private company, West Coast Paper Mill, was started at Dandeli. West Coast Paper Mill, private company owned by private company, was established at Dandeli. Bamboo, eucalyptus, tree pulp from nearby forest water from the Kali River and electricity from Jog are supplied to this mill. So raw materials as well as basic factors of production that is required for the establishment of this industry, that is West Coast Paper Mill, was provided with the bamboo and eucalyptus tree pulp from the nearby forest, water from the Kali River and electricity from the Jog Falls supplied to this industry. There are some more paper mills at Nanjangud, Krishna Rajanagara, Nanjangud and Krishna Rajanagara, Satyabala, Mundagod and Munirabad, Yediyuru and Bengaluru. In these places we can see few more important paper mills that is established in Karnataka and greatly contributed for the development of Karnataka. Karnataka ranks fourth in the production of paper in the country. So compared to other country, in the states of India, Karnataka ranks fourth related to the production of paper. Karnataka produces total 3.6 lakh tons of paper products per year. Even though we are producing more, but still India is depending on the import of paper. What is produced that is not enough for the requirement of Indians. Next comes cement industry. Since urbanization and industrialization has increased in Karnataka, the demand for cement in construction activities also increased. Now, what is the importance? Everybody know about that. What is the importance of cement in a present day, isn't it? Cement is essential for constructing houses, public buildings, roads, bridges, dams, etc. Everywhere we need the use of that is a cement. So without cement, nowadays it is very difficult. Limestone, which is necessary for the establishment of cement industry, is found abundance in Karnataka. Karnataka abundantly blessed with limestone that is best suited for the production of cement. In addition, gypsum and bauxite are also available. Only coal has to be imported from the neighboring states. Availability of water, sand, transport, electricity supply, clay and wide market are the other factors favoring the growth of cement industry. So what are the factors of productions are required for the establishment of cement industries? That is coal, that is already gypsum and bauxite that is available in our nation, our state only. And one more is limestone that is also available and other things that is imported from other states of India, that is neighboring states. The important factors are required are water, sand, transport, electricity supply, clay and wide market. Everything is available in the state. That's why cement factory also established and it was well developed in Karnataka. The first cement factory in the state was established at Bhadravati in the year 1939. Cement industry also established at Bhadravati in 1939. Later factories were set up at Bagalkot, Amma Sandra of Tumakuru district and Sahabad of Kalaburgi district. In these places also cement industries were established in Karnataka. Other cement producing centers are Wadi, Lokapura, Ittigihali, Madakere, Kanchipura, Kaladagi, then Kurukunta, Sedam and Chittapura. In these places also the famous cement industries were established. Karnataka produces total 8% of total cement in the country. Total 8% of country's cement was produced in Karnataka. At present it has an annual production capacity of around 121 lakh tons. Next, about the information technology industries. Karnataka is an important center of information and technology in India. So now present world is famously called as information technology world, isn't it? So Karnataka's contribution is also really great related to the development of information technology. Information and technological industries have made great progress here. since there are numerous engineering colleges, research centers, computer based technological courses and abundance of highly skilled manpower. So why this information technology that established in Karnataka, well developed in Karnataka? The reasons are establishment of numerous engineering colleges, research centers, computer based technological courses and abundance of highly skilled manpower. So all these are useful for the development of information technology. Therefore, many software industries have been established in Karnataka. Today, Karnataka occupies a very high position in India in this regard. So, Karnataka is related, contribution of Karnataka is great related to the information technology that is helped in the development of the country, India. So, this much about this lesson. The last part of this lesson is deleted for this academic year. Only this much for your studies, that is about iron and steel industry, cement industry, sugar industry, cotton textile industries, and one more is about the informational technology.